हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू सुफा ई क्लास। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस द क्रैमर्स मेथड और डिटर्मिनेंट मेथड ऑफ सॉल्विंग द साइमल्टेनियस इक्वेशंस। सो स्टूडेंट, वी हैव सीन हाउ टू फाइंड द डिटर्मिनेंट डी, डी एक्स एंड डी वाई। नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू मूव टुवर्ड्स एन एग्जाम्पल बाई विच वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड द डिटर्मिनेंट मेथड ऑफ सॉल्विंग द साइमल्टेनियस इक्वेशन। So here one example is given to us, solve the following simultaneous equation. So this first equation is 5x plus 3y equal to minus 11 and 2x plus 4y equal to minus 10. So student, let us compare these equations with the equation a1x plus b1y equal to c1 and this equation with a2x plus b2y equal to c2. So these are nothing but the standard form of that simultaneous equation. So here if you will consider, a1 will be equal to 5, b1 will be equal to 3 and c1 will be equal to minus 11, a2 will be equal to 2, b2 will be equal to 4 and c2 is equal to minus 10. So student, let us find the value of this determinant D. So we know that determinant D is equal to a1, a2, b1, b2. So we have to substitute the value of a1, a2, b1, b2 here. So you know that a1 is 5 here, so we'll write 5. And a2 is 2, and now b1 is 3 and b2 is 4. So student, let us solve this. So I have shown you in the previous lecture how to solve the determinant and how to find the value of determinant. So let us multiply this 5 multiplied by 4. So it will be 5 multiplied by 4 minus 2 multiplied by 3. So student, this will be equal to 5 4s are 20 minus 2 3s are 6. So this will be equal to 14. So student, now we will find the value of dx. So the determinant of x, that is dx, will be equal to c1, c2, b1, b2. So here c1, c2, b1, b2. So student, now substitute the values here. c1 is minus 11. So we'll write here minus 11. And c2 is minus 10. So we'll write minus 10 here. Now after that, b1 is 3 and b2 is 4. You can get the values of this c1, c2, b1, b2, a1, a2 from this equation. So student, let us solve this. Now negative 11 multiplied by 4 minus 10 multiplied by 3. So student, in this way we can also solve this. So minus 11 multiplied by 4 minus 44. Now this will be minus, and minus 10 multiplied by 3. So this will be minus 30. So student, it will be equal to minus 44, and this negative negative will become positive, so it will be positive 30. So the value of this dx is nothing but this negative 14. This is positive 30 and this is negative 44. So it will be 30 minus 44, that will be minus 14. So student, now we will find dy. So you know that dy is nothing but a1, a2, c1, c2. So we can write the values here. So here a1 is 5, a2 is 2, and now c1 is negative 11 and c2 is negative 10. So now let us solve this. So student, 5 multiplied by negative 10, that is 5 multiplied by minus 10 minus 2 multiplied by minus 11. So student, 5 multiplied by negative 10, that is negative 50 minus, and negative 11 multiplied by negative 2, that will be, so this will be negative, will be as it is. So 2 multiplied by minus 11, it will be minus 22. So now student, minus 50, this minus minus will become plus, and this 22 will be as it is. So here the value of this determinant is 22 minus 50, that is why minus 28. So student, you can see here we have find the value of d, dx and dy. So the value of d is equal to 14. Now dx is equal to minus 14 and dy is equal to minus 28. Now we have seen in the previous lecture how to find the value of x and y if we have the values of this d, dx and dy. So student, here we have to find the value of x. So for value of x, we will take here x is equal to dx upon d, as we have seen in the previous lecture. So this x will be equal to dx upon d. The value of dx is negative 14 here. So negative 14 upon the value of d is 14. So x will be equal to this 14, 14 will be cancelled up, and the value of this x will be negative 1. So this is the value of x. Now we'll find the value of y. So y is equal to dy upon d, as we have seen in the previous lecture, and dy is nothing but minus 28 here. So minus 28 upon 14, because the value of d is 14 here. So y will be equal to 14 ones are 14, 14 twos are 28, this will be negative 2. So you have seen that we have got the value of x and y. So the solution of the given equations is negative 1 comma negative 2. So this can be written in the ordered pair. So in ordered pair, first we will write the value of x, and then we will write the value of y. So student, you have seen that how we have solved the simultaneous equation by Cramer's method. So in this way, you have to take some more examples in order to do the practice. So note this example in your notebook, try to solve the question from the solved example, and try to solve the question from the practice set. So this is all about the today's lecture. Now we will move towards the next topic in the next lecture. Thank you.